Hello there, welcome back to my EU4 campaign where I played as Holland and formed the Netherlands. This is the timeline of events. I'm just going to show the games that started in 1444 and how I expanded the little three provinces of Holland into, you would say, a world-spanning empire. So without further ado, let's get started. I've got a rough idea of when things happen, so I know how to zoom out. Hopefully this will work. It's probably the hardest time I'm going to done. Most of the games I play kind of stay in the one area and just go outwards. But this one, obviously spread out to other places around the world. Took Breda pretty early on. Already in my independence, I imagine. There's Utrecht and Gelre. I think all I needed from here was Friesland to actually form the Netherlands. That was the last thing. Maybe Friesland, maybe even Groningen as well, now that I think about it. What's happening here? It's a bit of a slow time. Nation of Friesland stays. We've got Limburg, that's right. That was a good manpower producing province, that one. Very slow going plan in Europe, that's what I've learnt from this game. Aggressive expansion hurts a lot, and obviously the HRE makes it hard to do things freely, and if you can, definitely a different style of the game. Alright, there's Friesland and Groningen, so forming the Netherlands shouldn't be too far away from here. Boom, there it is! Orange, without oversticked. And I took Oost-Friesland though. And still slowly expanding. Right, there's over six, and now one full nation. That looks much better. And then this is where I start doing some colonizing. So let's just zoom out a bit. So there's the Netherlands in the corner. And there's my first American colony, Beothuk. And after there, I will expand down to here. Swanendaal. Okay. And after doing that, I will start a colony in Brazil. There it is. Maranhão. And then I move on to South Africa. There it is. Lesser Namaqualand. So it's a lot of colonies spreading out. About 30 years I went to North America, to Brazil, to South Africa. And then another 25 years from there, I will make landing in Australia on the western coast. There's Dutch South Africa. I kicked out Portugal from South Africa. I claimed it all for my own. Well, that was a pretty good move. And there it is, WA has been colonised, and not too long after I took the Wurundjeri province in central Victoria, basically where I live. Sri Lanka has been taken already, and there's my first colonies in Indonesia. Nothing else changes over here, so I'm going to zoom in a bit now on this part of the world. This is where a lot of the fun comes. Taiwan won't be too far off either, I would imagine. Now we can just see here how things change. Still growing a little bit in the mainland. And I'm just spreading my land in Indonesia and Malaysia mostly. There's Taiwan. Done. The mission complete. South Africa grows a bit, but then the rest of the game focuses on either Europe or Indonesia and Malaysia. So I'm going to zoom in as best I can on that area of the world, like so. And see, I'm making big grounds in Indonesia, destroying Malacca. And then Britain try and get involved, those rascals. So I took over some more Vijay Nagar. That all just kicked in then. And that's roughly how the game ends, I believe. And I do another war in India, that's right. The war over there is done. Not the best time on this one, I realise. I think it's just too... I've spread out too far over the whole world, that's for sure. Oh, I took Iceland as well. What about that one? There's the Maldives and a bit more of India taken. And I'll finish up taking Makassar. So I've got Dutch Indonesia. There it is, that's how it ended. So my final takings for the whole game were the Netherlands, which ended up reasonably big since I started out with just those three provinces. I expanded out and out up to pretty much what was left of Denmark. And I guess all through Belgium I've taken, it looks like. I took Iceland, Dutch Iceland, that's up there. Still kept Beothuk, my American colony, or my Canadian colony. Kept Dutch Delaware, my American colony. Dutch Brazil survived. Dutch South Africa got quite big. Couldn't quite get rid of Spain, but that was too risky. Took a little bite of Madagascar. I conquered the Maldives. Conquered Sri Lanka as whole and the tip of India. Took over the western half of Australia and a lot of the southern half as well. A lot of Indonesia and Malaysia in my hands. Almost all of Borneo. That was my goal. Couldn't quite pull it off though, unfortunately. It's because it's such quality land. And lastly, Taiwan. So the Dutch Empire definitely spread around the whole world by the end of the game, that is for sure. And that was the end of that. So I was quite happy with how that campaign worked out. My initial goal was just to form the Netherlands and get the Steam achievement. And I'm surprised how far I took it from there, even managing to complete every mission in the tree. But that is it. So thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate your support. I will play through the credits now, as I do for all my games that I play. I think it's only fair to give the producers and the developers credit for the game as well, since I do enjoy it so much and share that with you guys. So I'll play through the credits. That will be the end of this campaign. So thanks again. I appreciate your support through these games, and I hope to see you next time.